Hello world, Mr. Resistor here, continuing our temporarily Omega journey. And let's see. Got some of these. Okay, looks like manufacturing's gonna do it for us. Points wise. Oh, I left my wreath in that other system. Okay. Well, let's go ahead and take care of this first. Also have some ammo. Okay, so a couple of questions have been asked recently, which I answered in comments, but I figured it was worth mentioning more broadly because. Some of it was stuff that took me a long time to figure out, and you know, it's not necessarily hard to find the information, but you gotta know what to search for. So, first was about corporate projects and contributing to them. So, basically, if there is a project, so I set up. Okay, so I've got these. For Scordite, right? You've probably seen me when I do mining on this character, I typically pick up Scordite. That's because on my manufacturing character, pyrite seems to be the thing that I run out of most frequently. So typically, when I do big mining operations, I keep the Scordite for myself and I sell the feldspar and plagioclase. Excuse me. But I set up these delivery contracts basically just as an easy way to make to do buyback, right? So a lot of corporations and sometimes people who run mining fleets will do buyback, meaning that they will pay you for the ore that you mine, you know, under their auspices or with their with their boost or something, right? If you join a public mining fleet, usually the person, you know, person running it will be in an orca. They'll be providing boosts and compression, and often will offer buyback, right? And so 90% JITA is just kind of the standard, but you know, there might be different policies depending on the fleet that you're in. Anyway, all of that is just to say I set these up specifically for this character to easily sell ore without having to transport it to JITA or to try and like compress it or any, you know, to sell it to HiSec buyback or anything like that. But if you were a member of my corporation and you wanted to contribute, how would you do that? So the first thing is you have to be in a base where the corporation has an office. In this case, it's Olbra. That's the only office that my corporation has. So this is where you gotta be. And then in corporate hangars here in your inventory, there's this projects folder. I'm gonna click on that. It says you don't have the required role to view these contents. And that's fine. This character does not have access to basically anything, right? I'm treating this character as someone unknown and untrusted, right? So, but you don't have to be able to view it. If I had any of these, as you've seen me do many times, I just drag and drop it onto that folder, and that automatically contributes it to these. Right, so you can see the record here of who's contributed, right? Which is just this character. Anyway, that's the deal with that. The other question was related to skill plans, and I think we can talk about that while we travel because this is gonna be slow. All right. Should check our vicinity, see if there's any sites nearby.
Warp drive
Combat
active.
anomalies. Vildar. This one is always in Eister. It's the start of the Minmatar Epic quest chain, which I have never done. Probably should at some point, but okay, we got a couple Tetramon bases in Alterner. Maybe that will have changed a little bit by the time I get back from this. Right, skill plans. Okay, so we've all seen this before, and you can see I've got a skill plan called Magic 14, if you're not familiar with that. So that is a corporate plan, right? It's shared so that it's easily accessed by anyone who is a member of my corporation.
Warp drive active.
And let's see. Show skill plan contents. So essentially, the Magic 14, I didn't make up that name. These are the skills that that have the most effect on what modules you can fit on a ship, right? So CPU management gives you more CPU, power grid management gives you more power grid, capacitor systems operation. So anyway, there's 14 of them that are kind of considered the basics that you need no matter what you're
Warp
gonna do
drive
in the game,
active.
right? These are gonna be beneficial to you. And so they're generally considered to be like the highest priority skills to train. as I said, there are 14 of them, and hence the name Magic 14, right? So CPU management, power grid management, capacitor systems operation, shield operation, mechanics, signature analysis, navigation, warp drive operation, spaceship command, hull upgrades, long range targeting, evasive maneuvering, and is that it? No.
Docking permission requested.
Capacitor management, shield management. Yeah, okay. Docking, I think that's all of them. Anyway, I made this plan a while back. It's all kind of in order. It's all ordered for fastest training, right? So it's all the, you know, level one, then level two, just kind of, and then ordered by time. The only exception here being, right, long range targeting, I believe, requires CPU management too. Right, so that's why that would be there. right, and again, evasive maneuvering has as a prerequisite navigation too. So that's why that's there. Anyway, I don't know if there's a way to share skill plans other than like within a corporation. If there is, let me know. I'd be happy to make it public, I guess, or whatever. Link it somewhere, paste it. I don't know. I wish that there had been an existing skill plan so that I didn't have to make it. Because, you know, took some time. It was a little bit of a pain. That's all I need. Going to Meister.
Warp drive active. Drive active. drive active.
Annoying. It should be identifying those. We remember to bring our key chips this time, so we're gonna... Right.
Warp drive active.
So they don't get auto-targeted by everyone who jumps into the grid. Thank you. I've had bad luck trying to transport skin, so I'm gonna go ahead and use that instead of trying to get it to my Amar character. Although, I don't know if it's even possible for me to get in one of those. Only 10 of those. Huh. I feel like I normally get more. Got two stations here. Jump into the Minmatar one. What's this? Oh, you should cut it. Then we're gonna run this second Crimson Gauntlet here. Thank you.
Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
That's where I left that. Right. Okay. Anyway. Forgot to repair my drones. It'll probably be fine.
Warp drive active.
So as I mentioned the other day, the bounty payout for these Crimson Gauntlet kills are pretty good. I don't believe I've gotten any bounties for the Tetramon. That might be because they're not pirates. Or maybe it just depends on which faction I'm registered as fighting for. I don't know.
Thank you.
Okay. Just to be neighborly. Not that it's likely to matter. So you can see it deducted one of the shortcut key passes. So I started with 6 of these ones. To my own life. My own shields, I should say. Too busy watching my drones. again.
A module has run out of charges.
I almost forgot to collect a reward. So then I wouldn't have gotten the credit for the battleship when it dies.
Drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted. Thank you. Warp drive active.
Alright. Well, I'll probably do more of these sites tomorrow. But I'll still head back to Ulbra. Just in case I need to do some manufacturing also to get my points. I feel like I screwed that up somehow. Which almost certainly means it's time for me to be done. I can't only have 10 of these. How is that? How is that possible? I should have at least 28.
Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
All right. Well, I'm not going to think about it too much right now. I didn't trash him, did I? I wouldn't be that dumb. No, I wouldn't be that dumb. Yeah, I don't know. Whatever. We did the thing we meant to do today. And, I think that's gonna be it for me for today. So, until next time, have a good one.